97.3 City FM. Relevant radio, always.
When you are talking about trade facilitation, customs clearance, and facilitation in general, you are talking about three key ministries. In fact, the dominant ministry when it comes to doing business, which is an index, is Ministry of Transport, which is responsible for Ports and Harbors Authority and the airports. So the processes which result in demurrage and whatever have really nothing to do with customs. When you're items come and they are loaded into the warehouse, the length of time it takes until certain processes take place before customs take over. And then when customs take over, theirs is the duty, you know, illicit checking and other elements of it. There are three core customs functions: valuation, classification, and inspection. For a very long time, Ghana has ceded, you know, in tandem with many, many, many countries, from the pre-shipment inspection days to destination inspection, the valuation and classification function to pre-shipment and destination inspection. The World Customs Organization has said that it's not good practice because these are core customs functions. And even when you take the FCVR, which is what the DIs were using, there's a disclaimer that the ultimate responsibility for valuation is customs. So many countries have moved away from that. I think we should know that is the principal change that we are making to put back, like many countries have done, and I have done, if I have advised countries in this transition in my other life, from the Caribbean to Eastern Europe to elsewhere, to strengthen customs. So the core thing we are doing is to revert the valuation, classification, and inspection functions to customs to enable them. In fact, many of the employees of these DIs are ex and current customs officers who move out. And in fact, customs perform support. Now, the West Blue is a single window. As I said, many institutions are involved in the clearance procedure. And the idea, back to electronics again, the idea is to put a platform in place so that Port Health, Standards, you know, Authority, Customs, you know, anybody, Ports and Harbors itself, you know, which is part of the platform, do things electronically in order that we can eliminate the manual, you know, systems. To facilitate. Many countries are moving in that direction. That is the element that we are talking about. And it will be based on the same, you know, importer-based fee principle, including exports. That is the principle on which it's going to be based. The contract is being worked on, and there would come sometime because customs has
to... It has not been entered.
It's not been signed yet. Then we had the draft, the AG, Ministry of Finance, and our Tax Policy Unit, GRA, are looking at it. And it will be signed pretty soon. You know, we've got the authorization. You know, of course, I understand that there's a case in court, so of course it will be subject to the courts. We don't want to flout that. But the important thing is that come September 1st, the DI contracts have been terminated. And it's important. Customs is currently putting the systems in place in conjunction with the institution, you know, that has to do this. So let me repeat, the core thing we are doing is to revert valuation, classification, and inspection to customs.